Hey folks, another quick video here with a couple of practice problems on how to read a graph. So if we have a function that's given graphically like this, we might be asked for which values of x is f of x equal to 0. And remember that when we say f of x, really that's just another way of talking about y. So we're looking at the points on this graph and asking ourselves, when does the y equal 0? Well, y equals 0 is the x-axis, so we're looking for places where my graph crosses the x-axis. And we see that that happens twice, at x equals negative 5, and at x equals 9. So the answer to this question would be that x equals negative 5, or x equals 9. We get two solutions. Similar question here, we're asked for which values of x is f of x greater than 0. So again, remembering that f of x is really just y, we're looking where is the y above 0. So that means that on the y-axis, we want to know when does this function go above the x-axis? In other words, when are my y-values positive? So we can see that the y-values are positive all the way from the point negative 12, 4 up to the point negative 5, 0. And so all of the x-values in between negative 12 and negative 5 are values where the y is greater than 0. Not just the labeled dots that we see there, right? Not just negative 12, negative 9, and negative 7, but all the x values in between, because the function is a continuous curve that goes through all those points. So don't just pay attention to the labeled dots, pay attention to the whole function. So for this part of our function, our answer would be that we want x to be between negative 12 and negative 5, and so we would write that in an equality as x greater than negative 12 and x less than negative 5. So that's just a way to write this word between using less than signs. Now, we also want to include negative 12 itself, because at this point, negative 12, 4, the y really is positive. So we include negative 12 in our inequality. We don't include negative 5, because at this point, negative 5, 0, the y value is 0. Not greater than 0, it's equal to 0. So we don't include negative 5 for that reason. So this is part of our solution. But if we notice, if we look over here to the right, my function, the y value becomes positive again. For all values of x between 9 and 13. And again, we want to include 13 because that y value is positive. We don't want to include 9 because that y value is 0, and 0 is not positive. So I'd get two inequalities for my solution here, negative 12 less than or equal to x less than negative 5, and 9 less than x less than or equal to 13. Finally, we might be asked, what is the domain of f of x? For this, we're just trying to find out what are all the different x values that we could plug into our function. And again, you want to pay attention to more than just the labeled dots. We see that our function is defined all the way from x equals negative 12 up to x equals positive 13. So the domain here is all values of x such that negative 12 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 13. So again, that's just a symbolic way of saying x is between negative 12 and 13, including both negative 12 and 13. So that's a lot of words that we would have to write, and when we do it with symbols, we don't have to write as much. So it's a way of sort of having a notational convenience, as we say.